Hello guys, Scion Recap is here. Today's, I am going to explain to you, Dragon Ball Part 11. If you have not seen part before, go and watch it, or else this video don't make any sense, link in the description. Watch out and take care. Goku, who is furious and distraught, grabs his power pole and the dragon radar from Bulma and flees in the direction of the murderer despite Master Roshi's orders to stop. Goku uses the dragon radar and his stolen Dragon Ball to find the murderer. Roshi is startled to learn that the strange sign on a piece of paper that Oolong finds nearby is actually the mark of the legendary demon King Piccolo. The others listen as Master Roshi describes a time when the world was invaded by monstrous creatures that seemed unstoppable and tore through civilization, destroying everything in their path. The monsters eventually made it to Mutato's dojo, where the entire school engaged them in combat. Only a few of the monsters are defeated, and only two students, Master Roshi and Master Shin, made it out alive. The two were targeted by a joint mouth blast that the monsters had prepared and unleashed, but the two focused their energy into a shield and returned fire, slaying the creatures. Then King Piccolo appeared in front of them and fired a single blast at the earth in front of them, sending them flying into a section of the dojo. As soon as Master Mutato intervened, Master Mutato was Master of Roshi. King Piccolo quickly dispatched him, humiliating him in front of his pupils, and left him for dead. After being restored to health, Mutato abandoned them both. Roshi retained his faith, but Shin eventually lost it. King Piccolo continued his rampage. Years later, Mutato came back to Master Roshi from the adjacent mountains where he had taken sanctuary with an electronic rice cooker. After putting in a lot of practice, Mutato eventually trapped King Piccolo in a jar using the evil containment wave technique. Master Mutato used his all energy. He was not able to stand again. He gave his life to save others. Master Roshi established the Turtle School based on Mutato's teachings after personally tossing the jar into the ocean. Over time, humankind rebuilt civilization and completely forgot about King Piccolo and his clan's escapade around the globe. However, after discovering the jar, Emperor Pilaf freed King Piccolo and asking the Namekian bad guy to assist him in gathering the Dragon Balls. However, King Piccolo had other ideas and gave Tambourine orders to kill all surviving competitors in world martial arts tournaments, viewing them as potential threats. Goku eventually finds Tambourine and challenges him to a fight, but Tambourine easily outclasses him and destroys the flying Nimbus. Tambourine then proceeds to beat Goku senseless and knock him to the ground, where he assumes he is dead. In the middle of a forest, Goku wakes up battered and starving. He soon comes across a giant fish being cooked over an open fire. He is then accused of eating Yajirobe's fish when he is approached by him shortly after. The two then engage in a brief combat in which they are evenly matched, with Goku amazed that Yajirobe can withstand his blows, and Yajirobe equally astounded by how quick and powerful Goku is. Tambourine, meanwhile, kills several more combatants, including Bacterian, Nam, King Chapa, Pamput, Manwolf, and Jiren. Then, King Piccolo hatches Symbol, a new son whose mission is to locate the Dragon Balls. Symbol attacks Yajirobe as a result of the fact that he possesses one. He is killed by Yajirobe, who then eats him because he is starving. King Piccolo then commands Tambourine to attack them in retaliation for Symbol's death, but Goku is now at full strength and easily kills him with his Kamehameha, completely vaporizing him in the process. Because he desired to consume another creature of that magnitude, Yajirobe is furious. Master Roshi, Kaiatsu, and Teen search for the Dragon Balls in the meantime. King Piccolo promises Emperor Pilaf a fifth of his wealth when he tells him that he intends to summon the eternal dragon Shenron to young again and then conquer Earth. King Piccolo, who is furious at the deaths of his sons, turns to face Goku directly, while Roshi and crew discover the three-star Dragon Ball in a cave and travel to the location of the battle between Goku and King Piccolo. King Piccolo has the upper hand despite his advanced age, easily defeating Goku. When King Piccolo discovers that Goku's heart has stopped, he believes he is dead. Then he removes the one-star Dragon Ball from Goku's still form and walks away. Yajirobe, who had been hiding nearby, learns that Goku's heart had just briefly stopped and that the young fighter was still alive after Piccolo left. Knowing that he is no match for King Piccolo, Master Roshi simply remains put and endures King Piccolo's blows after luring him with two Dragon Balls and engaging him in combat. King Piccolo doesn't acknowledge Roshi until he mentions Mutato, at which point he becomes alarmed upon understanding what Roshi is there to accomplish. Master Roshi performs the evil containment wave after using a capsule to summon an electric rice cooker. He then almost successfully traps King Piccolo once more but just misses the jar's opening. King Piccolo is reassured by Master Roshi that he hasn't yet won and that someone would triumph, where he failed before he perishes from employing the move. King Piccolo is assured by Master Roshi that he has not yet triumphed and that someone else will succeed where he failed. King Piccolo summons Shenron since there is no one left to stop him. Teen is helpless because Master Roshi immobilized him previously with a knockout potion, Kaiatsu is too frail, and Goku is too hurt. Kaiatsu tries to stop him by wishing for his demise, but the Makosan strike of King Piccolo kills him before he can finish. When King Piccolo makes the wish to regress to youth, his strength soars to unprecedented heights. King Piccolo regains his youth, and as a demonstration of his renewed might, he uses a mouth energy wave to kill Shenron, destroying the Dragon Balls in the process. No longer possessing the Dragon Balls, King Piccolo's victims cannot be revived. To collect some Senzu beans, Goku begs Yajirobe to carry him to Korin Tower. Fortunately, Yajirobe has a car of his own, in a capsule. Goku tries to ascend, but given his state, he asks Yajirobe to carry him up the tower as they move along.
Thank you guys, this is the end of the video, please make sure to like the video. It takes only 1 second, but that's a lot for me. Okay guys, good luck.